And now we can turn to considering examples of spaces of functions. And we'll begin by considering the space of continuous functions on a closed interval and equipped with the P norm, which is defined using the integral, as in the previous videos. And our aim here is to prove that this space is not a space, not a Banach space, and this we can do by constructing a Cauchy sequence, which we can also show that does not converge to any limit inside the space. And for this purpose, we define a function depicted here in the figure, which is identically zero from minus one to zero, then rises steeply from 0 to 1 on the interval from 0 to 1 over t equals 1 over n, and then is constant and equal to 1 until t equals 1. And in this sequence, when the index n increases, the interval of the rising from 0 to 1 gets shorter and shorter, and correspondingly the slope of the rise gets steeper and steeper. And in order to study the Cauchy sequence property, we take two functions of the sequence for some arbitrary n and m and compute the norm of their difference. And here we can simplify the formulas a bit by directly considering the pth root of the norm, so that we don't need to write down the pth root in the definition. And by definition, these two functions have identical values from minus 1 to 0. And then again, after both functions have risen to the value 1 from t equals the maximum of 1 over n and 1 over m until t equals 1. And for this reason also, the integrated difference is only non-zero between the value 0 and the maximum of the 1 over n and 1 over m. And on this interval, which becomes very short when n and m increase, we can make quite a crude estimate by using the triangle inequality here to estimate the difference between these values with the absolute values of the sum of the absolute values of them. And when we remember that both of these values are at most 1, we can further estimate the term to be integrated by 2 to the power p and take it out of the integral. After this, we're only left with the length of the interval, which is precisely 1 over the minimum of the indices n and m. And this bound that we have here shows that the p norm of the difference between fn and fm indeed converges to zero when both n and m increase without bound. And because of this, what we've shown is that the sequence fn is actually a Cauchy sequence. So if the space was a Banach space, the sequence fn should converge in the p norm to some continuous function f, which is the limit of this sequence. But in the case of this particular sequence that we have, we can show, as is written down in the lecture notes, that if such a continuous function f, the limit of the sequence, exists, then necessarily all of its values for t, which are negative, have to be equal to zero. And in addition, for all positive t, the function should have value 1. But this kind of a situation, of course, cannot happen for any continuous function. And this is a contradiction with the assumption that the limit f is inside our space of continuous functions. And for this reason, the sequence fn does not converge, even though it's a Cauchy sequence. And this means precisely that our space is not a Banach space. And as we see in the case of this sequence, we really have a situation where we can very easily picture the correct limit of our sequence, or a natural limit for this sequence. And this is the function having values equal to 0 from minus 1 to 0, and then jumping to the constant value 1. For positive values of t. But in terms of the convergence of the sequence, the problem is that the limit function here is, of course, discontinuous and outside our original space, and that's why our sequence fails to converge in the space of continuous functions. And for our next example, we can change the norm on the same vector space and see what happens to the same sequence of functions when we study its convergence properties using the infinity norm, which we recall to be defined using the supremum. And what we will see in this example is that the sequence of fn is actually not a Cauchy sequence with respect to the infinity norm. And indeed, if we look at the difference between the two functions, fn and fm, in the case where m is much larger, at least twice the size of fn, we can always find a point t where the difference of values between these two functions is exactly 1/2. And this is because at the halfway between 0 and 1 over n, the function fn, plotted in green here, has value equal to 1/2. And because m as an index is much greater, the function fm already has value equal to 1. And since in the infinity norm, the supremum of the values of the difference, fn and fm, is always bounded from below by the sizes of this difference at individual points, we can see that this difference really does not converge to 0 whenever the indices n and m grow. And this is direct conflict with the definition of a Cauchy sequence, so we can deduce that fn is not a Cauchy sequence with respect to the infinity norm. So our observation that fn is not a Cauchy sequence means that we cannot use the same reasoning as in the case of the p norm to argue that the space of continuous functions on a closed interval with the infinity norm is not complete. And indeed, this known space actually is a Banach space. And roughly speaking, this completeness result especially means that the infinity norm ensures that the natural limit of any Cauchy sequence is always a continuous function. And as we also saw in our previous example, the condition for a sequence to be a Cauchy sequence with respect to the infinity norm is really stricter than the corresponding condition for the P norm. The proof of the completeness of the space has the following main steps. We begin with a Cauchy sequence Fk with respect to the infinity norm. From this, we can easily deduce that also for any fixed t0, the sequence of values of the functions fk at this point form a Cauchy sequence now in the space of complex numbers. But because the space of complex numbers is complete, every one of these sequences for different points t0 have well-defined limits in the space of complex numbers. And this way we can define a function f which consists precisely of these limit values. This pointwise convergence of these functions can in addition be shown to be uniform in with respect to the variable t. And finally, the uniform convergence theorem from real analysis implies that the limit function of the uniformly convergent sequence is continuous, and because of this it belongs to the space, and the proof is complete. And summarizing our examples, we've seen that our primary sequence spaces LP and L infinity are both Banach spaces, and the space of continuous functions on a closed interval is not a Banach space if we equip this space with the p-norm, but it becomes a Banach space with the infinity norm.